Once they receive their new Rolls-Royce F-130 engines, B-52As will become B-52Js, according to the Air Force's fiscal 2024 budget documents. The designation resolves a question that had been debated for several years, as the B-52 undergoes some of the most significant improvements in the H model's 61-year service life. Any B-52H aircraft modified with the new commercial engines and associated subsystems are designated as B-52J, the Air Force said in justification documents for its 2024 budget request. The service had been considering various designations for the improved Stratofortress, because in addition to new engines, the B-52 will also be receiving a new radar, as well as new communications and navigation equipment and weapons, among other improvements intended to keep it credible and capable through the 2050s. Given the number of major changes, Global Strike Command had considered using interim designations. J model aircraft would have then become B-52Ks. One of the improved weapons the B-52 was supposed to get was the hypersonic AGM-183 Air-Launched Rapid Response Weapon, ARRW, but in the 2024 budget, the Air Force said it's moving to close out the program after a couple more tests and shift its emphasis to the Hypersonic Attack Cruise Missile, HACM. The B-52 re-engineering project name has also evolved from the Commercial Engine Replacement Program, CERP, to CERP-RVP. For rapid virtual prototyping, the Air Force said in its budget request. The re-engineering effort was launched as a mid-tier acquisition in order to save time and get capability sooner. The program will become a major capability acquisition at the end of the RVP effort, the Air Force said. The upgrades will also open the door to other changes, USAF noted. As B-52 CERP brings additional capability to the B-52, emerging security/certification requirements, nuclear hardening, cybersecurity, program protection, etc., will also need to be addressed. Several concurrent aircraft upgrades during the B-52 CERP may necessitate temporary facilities or facility upgrades/modifications. The Air Force is asking for nearly $3 billion in B-52 procurement across the future year's defense plan, starting with a modest $65.82 million in 2024, but ramping up to over $1.1 billion each in 2027 and 2028. Of the overall amount, the radar modernization program alone claims $845.9 million, peaking in 27 at $271.95 million. Separately, not included in the procurement account, research, development, test, and evaluation associated with the radar modernization program is requested at $371 million, ending in 2026. The RMP procurement funding is to procure 74 radar kits, 3 training systems kits, and 2 engineering and manufacturing development kits. The new radar is a variant of the Raytheon N/AP-79, an active electronically scanned array, AESA, radar used on the Navy's F/A-18 Super Hornet fighter. It replaces the APG-166, which the Air Force says suffers from severe vanishing vendor issues and parts problems that will make the radar unsupportable before 2030. Besides a dramatic improvement in maintainability, the AESA will add significant new capabilities in search, ground mapping, and electronic warfare. The new radar's physical footprint is also much smaller than the system it replaces, creating growth capacity in the front of the aircraft. The B-52's nose-mounted electro-optical blisters will be removed and a new radome installed with the new radar. The re-engineering program is funded for $2.56 billion, all in the RDT&E budget, peaking at $650.5 million in 2025. The program seeks to replace the original equipment Pratt and Whitney TF-33 engines with Rolls-Royce F-130s. The change is expected to eventually pay for itself through 30% better fuel efficiency and elimination of engine overhauls, as the F-130 will not need an overhaul for the duration of its expected life on the B-52 wing. Along with the new engines, CERP will replace associated subsystems, such as engine struts and nacelles, the electrical power generation system, and cockpit displays, the Air Force said. The development, production, and installation of new engines and related subsystems will replace the legacy equipment on all 76 B-52H aircraft. including monies expended so far, the total cost of the B-52 CERP middle tier of acquisition effort will be $1.32 billion, including RBT&E, the Air Force said. The Air Force expects B-52 JIS, with both new engines and new radars, to be available for operational use before the end of the decade. The B-52H Stratofortress, affectionately known as the BUFF, Big Ugly Fat Fellow, has been a stalwart of the U.S. Air Force since its introduction in 1955. Despite its age, the B-52H has undergone continuous upgrades, enabling it to remain a highly effective and versatile platform for strategic bombing, reconnaissance, and electronic warfare. Equipped with a range of advanced weaponry and cutting-edge systems, the B-52H can deliver precision-guided munitions, standoff weapons, and nuclear payloads. Its unmatched endurance allows it to operate globally without requiring forward basing, making it an invaluable asset for missions that demand rapid response and sustained air power. The unsung heroes. 20th EBS Maintenance Airmen. While the B-52H may dominate headlines and awe onlookers, its ability to execute complex missions hinges on the skill and dedication of the 20th EBS maintenance personnel. These unsung heroes ensure that every component of the aircraft, from its engines to its avionics systems, is in peak condition. The B-52H's complexity is a challenge we embrace, says Senior Airman Jessica Ramirez, an aircraft maintenance technician assigned to the 20th EBS. Each system is critical, and our job is to make sure everything operates flawlessly, no matter the conditions or location. At RAF Fairford, the maintainers face unique challenges, including adapting to the unfamiliar environment and working under the pressure of operational timelines. Despite these obstacles, the team consistently demonstrated excellence, performing routine inspections, repairs, and even contingency troubleshooting on site. One of the primary goals of Bomber Task Force missions is to enhance interoperability with NATO allies. Joint exercises involving the B-52H and allied air forces ensure seamless coordination in real-world scenarios. These exercises often simulate missions such as joint strikes, air defense integration, and long-range precision engagements, showcasing the combined strength of NATO forces. The 20th EBS maintenance crew plays a critical role in these efforts. Their work not only ensures the B-52H's readiness, but also serves as a platform for collaboration with allied forces' maintenance teams.